Yes, so we'll wait for the technical. Okay, so Damien Oh, please.
Okay, hello, I'm Damien Oh, the editor-in-chief of Make Tech Easier. Okay, thanks for joining me today. The session I'm talking about is about managing multiple author or contributor or even editor in WordPress. Okay, so let's have a show of hand. How many of you are managing a team in WordPress? None? Quite a few here. Okay. So first of all, who the heck is me? Okay. I'm a tech enthusiast. Okay, some people call me a geek. In school time, a lot of girls call me nerd. Luckily, I'm not. Okay, I'm a ex WordPress developer. Okay. Why ex? Because I used to do a lot of freelance work developing WordPress themes, plugins, and I just grow tired of it. A lot of time, the client just think they know what they want, but in fact, they don't know. So I'm getting tired of that. So I say, stop developing. Yes, I'm a tech writer. I started writing in 2006. I first started writing as an internet marketing expert when I really don't know about anything. Okay, that's what people are doing anyway. So in 2007, I think I tired of writing something I don't know. So I switched focus. I started a site called Make Tech Easier, and I just write about something that I like. Okay, I'm an engineering background. So I love to make things easier to do, simplify things, automate stuff. So the idea of a blog is to make tech easier to do. So people come, people learn about the tutorial, tips, tricks, they get better in tech. Okay. And now I see less writing for me. Actually, I'm managing a team. So what is about Make Tech Easier? It's a tech site that focuses on how-to, tutorials, tips, tricks, hacks. Okay, one thing is we don't cover news. So our post, we can have something like iPhone 7 launched today. We don't have a Thursday, we must come up with a post tomorrow. So we can wait for some time, find all the things we need to write about, all the how-to. So we can publish probably about 1 month later about all the hacks. So this actually started in 2007. Okay. Now it's actually I have 28 staff under, and we cover a lot of topics including Windows, Mac, Linux, Android, web services, WordPress, almost everything tech related. We have about 3 to 5 articles per day, and we have over 2 million page views. Now this is how the site looks like. Okay, and so that's a topic that we are covering: Windows, Linux, Mac, web, browser, Chrome, gadgets, hardware, okay, a lot of things. And recently we actually launched premium services. We provide online courses, tutorials, yeah, and even ebooks, cheat sheet. And about our teams, we have 20 staff writers, 2 content editors, 1 copy editor, so 1 premium content editor, 2 course trainer, 1 managing editor, which is me. Okay, and the thing about my team is that everyone is working remotely. So none of them are in Singapore. So we actually communicate through internet, through the email, through WordPress. Okay. So what I'm going to talk about is what is our workflow and how we use that workflow to manage our writer. So first of all, we have a sourcing of post idea. Okay. And the writer themselves, they can come up with their own topics and they can pitch it to the editor and the editor approve it. Then once the topic is approved, they proceed to write, submit for reviews, editing. So for editing, we have 3 item. We look out for the content, we check out for facts, whether the tutorial works or not, is it true, the command line, is it correct, is there any error. Next, the second round of editing, we'll do SEO editing, check out the keywords, is it in appropriate places, the title, the permalink, all that. And last thing we go for is copy editing. We check for all the grammar, the spelling mistakes, and then we go live. So that is a flowchart. Okay, so the content editor will first source for post idea. They'll add them to the database. So the writer, they will check out the post idea section, and they will assign the topic they are interested to write. Alternatively, they can pick their own topic. So the editor will check through the topic and assign them accordingly. Okay, they'll start writing. Once they finish, they submit for content editing. That's the first round of editing. In the second round, we go for SEO editing. And the third round is copy editing. And lastly, we go live. So that is the workflow for us. So how are we going to manage them? So the challenge for us is how to make sure the editor and writer know what to do at each stage of the editorial process. Okay. Next is how do we make sure that the editor and the writer don't step on each other's foot. We don't want the editor to edit the article while the writer is still writing. We don't want the writer to publish the article without editing. Okay, so we don't want them to overlap each other's role. And how do you keep track of the progress of the article? So when the writer they pitch the topic and it's approved, how are we going to know that at what stage is she? Has she finished writing? Is it ready for review? Is it ready to go live? And last thing is we need to do everything in WordPress. Okay. So personally, I don't like to use third-party website to do all these things because we're talking about articles, so I want to do everything in WordPress. So there are a few things that we do. First of all, we assign custom user roles. So we create additional user role and map user to their role. So one plugin that we use is the members. It's a very popular plugin, members plugins. So we have a contributor. So they can edit posts, but they cannot publish. We have a co-editor. So they are the content editor, they are the SEO editor. They can edit other people's posts, but they cannot publish posts. And the last stage is a copy editor. They can edit other people's posts and they can publish posts. So that's how the plugin looks like. Yeah. So there are different roles. Okay, next thing, what we do is we set up some guidelines for the writer to follow. So one thing is I make the editorial guideline easy to access in WordPress. So when they log in, they will have to read the editorial guidelines. And anytime they forget about the guideline, they can go back to refer as well. So for new writer, we do hire new writer from time to time. So when they log into the site, they must read the guideline. It's a compulsory thing for them. And they must agree to follow. So it's something like a contractual agreement. So when they agree, so next time when we have something need them to amend and they refuse to, then we refuse to pay them because they agree to follow. Okay, and actually I built this plugin myself called the editorial plugins. Okay, so if you, so when a new writer login, you'll see a neck here, so a message, so you have to read this before you proceed. So when you click on this, okay, there's a sidebar here, and you can read it. So at the end, they have to agree and abide by this. Okay. Maybe I just do a quick demo. You can see. Okay, under this editorial guide, can see from far. Okay, so I have these settings. So this, you can add all these guidelines. As an administrator, you can add all these things. So this is what the writer, they will see from the site. So they can read everything they need to know about writing from us. Okay. So lastly, they will need to agree. Okay. So anytime they forget about any of the thing, just click on here. They can assess everything here. So there's no reason for them to write in the wrong way. Okay. Next, the post idea. So what I did is I create a custom post type called post idea. This one is not publicly available, so it means on the front end you won't be able to search it, but in the back end you can use it and add it as a post idea. So I create a page where the content editor can add in new post idea, and I create a page where the writer can view all the page idea, the post idea, and assign topic to themselves. So once again, I wrap everything in our own plugins. So for this is a under administrator login. So under post idea, I can add. So I can add. Okay, for example, iPhone 7 is launching. So I can add something like what you need to know about iPhone 7. So that's the post idea. So for the content brief, I can tell the writer what should this post be about. I can say everything. All the new features of iPhone 7. Okay. So let's say the keyword used, supposed to be used in this article, iPhone 7. I can publish it. So what is next? Under the post idea section, you can see all the article, all the ideas we have. Okay, this is the contributor login. So now let's say I'm logging as a writer. What I can do is I just, oh, this is a new topic, this is interesting. What I do, I just click assign to me straight away. Okay, the post has been assigned to you. So what I did is I just go to the post section. Hey, it's there. I can straight rewrite. Okay, I grab from a post idea straight away, put it under my post, and I start to write and finish, I submit. Next thing is a writing process. One thing that I recommend is using this plugin called Edit Flow. Okay. So what this thing, this plugin can do is actually it can allow you to add new custom post status. You can add editorial metadata, add editorial comments, notifications, and more. Basically, this is the whole thing that Edit Flow covers. It covers calendars, custom status, dashboard widget, editorial comments, metadata, notification. So you can enable, you can customize it for your own site. So what it is, we use Edit Flow, the custom post status. We actually set up different stages of writing process. So we have a pitch, assign, in progress. So that is when the writer, they pitch a topic. So when the editor, they approve a topic, they put it under assign. When a writer is writing, they put it under in progress. And when they are done, they submit for reviews. The first round of review is the content editor, they'll review it for the facts, the content. So if there's any changes that need to be made, you'll put it to need amendment, send it back to the writer to rewrite it. If it's fine, the next stage is the SEO. Okay. You can put pending SEO review, but I just put pending final reviews. Okay. And when this is done, we'll go to the last stage. It's ready to go live, where the copy editor will check for grammar, spelling mistake. When it's done, we go live. So that's the process we use to manage the article from a pitch all the way to the publish. So this is what we use in Edit Flow. It allows you to set up all the different status. Next, we also use the editorial comments and a notification to notify the writer, to tell them what went wrong with your article, okay, and what to amend and what to fix. So I can just say something, okay, this article is not good enough, it's not following a guideline, the image is not clear enough. Okay, I can just write and they'll receive an email saying, oh, this article, they need to be fixed. So they'll go in, check the need amendment status, change it, resubmit again. And the whole editing process start again. Okay, so some quick hacks that I use is actually I add a lot of quick links to the post status. For example, under the post, you can see normally you only see all posts, add new category. This what I did, I just put here so easy access. Okay. One thing that my writer actually requests is have a quick link to my assigned post. Why? Because if you go into WordPress under the post, you can see that you can sort, you can't sort by status and author at the same time. There's no option. Okay, I can select author, so you sort by my by the author post, but it doesn't sort by Damien O and in progress status. Doesn't do that. So what I did, I just do a quick hack. So I just put my assigned post, so you will sort by assigned post and the author name, which is quick link for them. One thing, next thing is I even put the post idea in the dashboard, so it's easier for them to check out. So they save them a click to go in the post idea section. They just look at the dashboard, log in, look at the dashboard. Hey, this is interesting. Check it out. Assign, right, simple. Okay, so a roundup of the plugin that I use, members. This actually can be used as a membership site also. It can be used on the front end and the back end as well, which is very useful. User role editor, it gives you a more fine-tuned control over your user permission capabilities. Edit flow, highly recommended. Editorial calendar. And if you are interested, I do share the plugin that I created, the post idea. DO is Damien O, you can say it's do. And the editorial guideline. So these are the plugin that I created. It's in the GitHub, so if you are interested, you can check it out as well. Okay, that's all. Any questions?
I have a very noob question actually. With regards to how you got from your one-man team, from yourself only, to where you were with so many people. Mm-hmm. How do you even get people to write for you at the start? I believe you don't pay them initially. How do you even find them? And then,
oh, we hire, we just place advertisements and look for writers. So initially, I started as a one-man blog. I started writing alone. So after we have some income, so it's enough to hire one person, so I just hire one more writer to help me out. So when I have more income to hire another one, I'll just hire another one to hire. So the process worked from 2 to 4 to 8, so until today.
So that means you pay them, you put out advertisement to hire people, and then
yep,
they come to you?
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, I think I'm also impressed by one person who like these staff writers.
Mm-hmm.
How do you decide whether it's better to between staff writer and freelancers? There are probably some advantages regarding hire people who work on a full-time basis versus on a freelance basis. So maybe like there are some disadvantages about hiring freelancers. So you think maybe the full-time should be a better idea or something like that?
No, in fact, most of my writers are freelancer. Okay, but I actually put them on the contract, so they have to fulfill a certain criteria. So it's not that they will do as and when they like. Okay, so I rather put them as a contract so I have more control over them. So a lot of the freelancers that I used to work with, they just leave as and when they like. So when they're supposed to submit an article this week, and they just disappear. So I got very angry, so I decided, oh, we put down the contract. So anything happen, we don't pay them.
So when you say staff writers, are they full-time employees? You have to pay whether they write or not, or they are contractors?
They are under contract.
They are contractors.
Contract. So they have a fixed number of articles they have to fulfill per month, and for a fixed price.
Okay, so it's like a contract, and they have to write certain amount of articles.
Yeah, for a writer, they are on a freelance basis, contract freelance basis, but for the editor, they are all full-time staff.
Okay. So you shouldn't have contractor as editors. The editor has to be full-time.
Yep.
Is there any reason the editor shouldn't be
the contractor? No, not really. Because I actually promote those writers to editors. So those editors, they have been with me for a long time, writing for me for a long time. So I promote them to editor and put them on a full-time basis.
Okay. So there is a need for the full-time staff, like contractor is not going to be enough, right?
Yeah.
I'm actually curious when you were going through the slides, the guidelines for the for your editors, right? Your writers to set the images to be 100 dB size and also less than 70k kilobytes. In the age that most of the images now are CDNs, is it really necessary?
Yes, because of server performance. So I'm very obsessed with good server performance. So I actually put a very strict rule on the images. Some of them, see the size is only so big. Okay, we don't talk about 2000 pixel wide, talking about probably about 800 pixel wide. So for that size of image, you don't really need to go above 100k. So if it's above 100k, then something has to be wrong. Because for the year that I've been writing, I never reached have an image that's over 100k. Yeah, that's why I impose such a restriction for my writers.
It's a good discipline.
Okay. Thank you. Okay.
What happens if a writer isn't able to fulfill their quota?
They don't get paid.
Say if it's through illness or is it just they don't get paid?
They don't get paid. Illness. They don't get paid, yeah. Because they have a contract with us.
Yeah.
Okay, is there no questions for Damien? No? Okay. Thank you so much,
Damien. Thank you.